So there are a few things in the modular environment that are unique and different from working with other synthesizers. And the modular environment is really like a playground for synthesis and sound design. So let's really have a look at a few ways we can explore sound design in modular. We will use VCVREC, but this will work more or less the same in hardware. One thing though, and this is not an issue in hardware, but I really recommend if you are working with VCVREC to get some sort of a controller that you can use to play with the sound with your hands. It really enhances the experience. So I have here the Modular controller and the keystep. Let's start with a few short sounds. Now, probably the first thing that comes to mind when patching in modular is the fact that we can patch things back into themselves and create interesting feedback loops. Most of the time, matrix mixers, like the one I have here, are being used for feedback patching because they allow us to route signals in all sorts of ways. But I want to show you that it's also possible to use a so-called simple mixer as well. So we have here a simple voice. I have here again, as I mentioned, the keystep playing the Bleak oscillator from Volt going through a VCA, and I have an envelope opening this VCA, and this is going through some delay and reverb. It will sound like this. And now we can route the delay, for example, back into itself and create a feedback loop. So first of all, we will use the mixer. So we will send the voice first into the mixer, into one channel of the mixer, and then from there to the delay. And we have the same sound, but now we can route the delay back into the mixer and create a feedback loop. So first of all, let's take the level of the second channel down, and actually, you know what, I will map it to the modular so you can also see it moving, as you can see it here. So I'm just using the one fader of the modular to move this fader on the mixer. So now I have control over the level, and in this case I'm going to use a mult. So if you are in hardware, it will be easier for you to follow, but in VCV there's no real need for mutes. But for now, I will send the delay first to a mult that I have here. So now we have three copies of this signal, and then I'm going to send it once to the reverb, just like we had it before, but also once back to the mixer, to input 2 on the mixer. So again, the delay is going to the mult, and from the mult it's going to the mixer, from the mixer back to the delay, and back to the mixer, and back to the delay, and so on and so forth. So we have a feedback loop, and it will sound more or less like this. Let's see here, for example. We can play with the sound a bit. Now with the delay it's not so special, but with reverbs, for example, it can get quite interesting. So let's do the same with the reverb. I will map another channel, the third channel, to another fader I have on the modular. I will also map actually the delay time, just so I have again a bit more control to change the sound live. And now I'm going to mult the reverb. So I'm going to take, let's say, the left channel to the mult, and then again once to the mixer, just like we to the main output, sorry, just like we had it before, and another time to another channel of the mixer. Now again, I can play this sound, and in this case, create a feedback loop with the reverb. The reverb will go to the mixer and back to the reverb, actually also through the delay. So there are two feedback loops here with the delay and the reverb. So let's have a listen to this. And I can play again with the delay time. You can create all sorts of risers, screams. Oh yeah. See a few octaves down. And again, you can really experiment with this. You can put other things in the feedback chain, like a filter, for example. So try also experimenting with filters. Let's go a bit higher, something a bit more painful. So if we are already dealing with delay and reverb, something special about Modular is the fact that we don't have to use so-called effects like delay and reverb at the end of the chain, but rather use them as instruments by themselves and make them an integral part of the sound. So here I have again a simple voice. Again, the key step in this case, it's controlling two Blick oscillators, and I have them going through Punch, which is a stereo VCA, and again an envelope controlling this VCA. And some reverb, it will sound like this. But now, instead of having the reverb at the end, like we have it here, I will place it before the VCA. So let's make some place for it. I will disconnect it first of all, and then I will place it before the VCA. So the two Blick oscillators will go first to the reverb, to plateau, and then to the VCA, and then to the main output, just like this. Let's see. So now it's a part of the sound, a part of the chain. Let's take the release a bit up. And maybe you know what, let's take the dry signal all the way down so we get only the wet signal from the reverb, but again, it's going first to the VCA. And again, also here, playing with the different parameters can really open up the sound. So let's map the size of the reverb. I will map it again to the Modular. So now I have control over the size. Let's see, maybe an octave up. Down. Really low. Or really high. Now this can work really nicely also with the delay. So what I have here, I have a few drums. I have the gate sequencer sequencing tremolo 2, and it's sequencing once the oscillator part, which is a sort of a kick. And it's sequencing also the noise part, which is a sort of a snare. Now what I'm doing here, as you can see, again, I'm multiplying, I'm multing, I'm creating a copy of this trigger. Again, this is for those of you who are using hardware, so it's easier to follow. In VCV, there's no need really for mults. And what I'm doing is this. So first of all, one copy is triggering the voice itself, and I'm sending this voice, this noise through a delay and then through a VCA. So again, the delay is a part of the chain. It's a part of the voice. So it's going through a VCA, and I have an envelope opening this VCA. This envelope is being triggered by a copy of this trigger from the sequencer. But I also use this trigger to trigger a sample and hold that changes the release time of the envelope. So sometimes there will be more delay going through, or sound with the delay going through, sometimes less, sometimes the sound will be shorter, sometimes longer, and it will create this effect of like a ghost notes. And again, this is a part of the sound, this is a part of the chain. And I'm also using the same sample and hold to modulate the time of the delay, so there is also some changes in the ghost notes. It will sound like this. So again, the delay is now a part of the sound. And sometimes we get more delay. Sometimes less delay with different delay times also. Very nice. So this is one thing we can do with the delay. I also have here a melodic voice. I have here the grid sequencer from JW sequencing the FM operator. This is going through another delay, the chronoblob 2. And again, this delay goes first through a VCA, which is punch in this case, a stereo VCA. And I have another envelope, just like with the snare, another envelope opening the VCA and sample and hold modulating the release time. So again, also with this melodic voice, sometimes there will be more delay, sometimes less, sometimes it will be longer, sometimes it will be shorter. It creates really lots of movement, lots of character. Again, this is a part of the sound. This is a part of the chain. And it's not just another effect at the end of the chain. I have here another example with reverb, like we've seen before. I'm using again the key step to play bleak, and I'm sending it through plateau. And now I'm sending the reverb, I'm sending plateau first through some saturation and wave folding. So this is another fun thing you can do in Modular. You can send reverbs into wave folders, which is can be quite interesting. So this is going through the Briatus, again for some folding and some saturation. And then it's going through a filter. And then, only then it goes through a VCA, and then I have an envelope opening this VCA. Again, everything is controlled with the key step. And I also have one control here. As you can see, this is the cutoff of the filter. It's mapped to the modular, so I can really play this voice. Let's have a listen. Thank you. Another interesting thing we can do in Modular is experimenting with noise. Now, noise exists also in other synthesizers, but in Modular we can use noise in all sorts of places in the chain. So here again, I have a simple voice. Again, the key step is controlling, in this case, the VCO1, and it's going through a filter and the VCA, and I have an envelope opening this VCA, and all of this is going through some reverb, so it will sound like this. By the way, I have control with the modular over the frequency of the filter. So I can play it a bit. And I have also the noise module from VCV. And we can start, for example, by sending the noise to the CV input of the filter. Also this, this attenuverter of the CV input I have mapped to the modular, so I can also increase and decrease it. Let's go with white noise. Listen to how much character this adds. Also on high frequencies. We can try also pink noise maybe, so it's a bit darker. Again, without and with. We can also try sending noise to the FM input of the oscillator. And also here I have the attenuator mapped to the modular. So let's go again with white noise and listen to the movement. We'll take the noise out of the filter a bit. Listen to the movement. And of course it can go also a bit more extreme. Frequencies. If you need a scream or a monster, send some noise. Oh yes, oh yes. Okay, we can also send noise into the reverb, so for example to the hold input of the reverb that will freeze the reverb. Let's see how this will sound like. Or instead of the hold to the wet amount. Oh. So just like with noise, we can route all sorts of signals into different destinations and get interesting results, especially at audio rates, so-called audio rate modulation, that is also possible in other synthesizers, but again, in modular, we can really explore it in more depth and complexity. So in this case, we will start with a triangle wave. I just have the key step, in this case, sending pitch information to the VCO1, and this is going through a VCA, a triangle wave is going through a VCA and some reverb. And I have here another oscillator, another VCO1 that we will use to explore modulation at audio rates. So of course, the most obvious is FM. I have again the Modular mapped, first of all, to the frequency of the oscillator and also to the FM CV amount. So let's start with a sine wave, for example. Again, this can work for all sorts of risers, all sorts of aliens. Let's try a saw wave. Do this for hours. And we can also try amplitude modulation, so using the VCO1 to modulate the VCA at audio rates. Maybe let's try a triangle wave. Maybe so. We can move both oscillators together if I just connect again the pitch. So if we find a sweet spot. So you can create monsters, but you can also create really really beautiful sounds. You can also try modulating the reverb at audio rates, so for example, the size. Let's just take this maybe a bit down. So let's take a saw wave to the size CV input. Oh. Audio rate modulation, always fun. Oh. And of course, feedback modulation is also quite interesting. So I'm going to use the reverb. I'm going to take one output of the reverb to modulate back the FM of the oscillator. So let's see. And maybe also the FM of the first oscillator. So again, we have this feedback. The reverb is modulating the oscillator and the oscillator is modulating the reverb. yes, oh yes, oh yes. Okay, so as you can see, the world of sound design in a modular environment is basically endless. Just don't forget to hit record before you start. And I hope that this video gave you some inspiration to go and explore some ideas with your system. Have fun and cheers. Yeah.